Hi, in this video drum lesson, I thought we'd take a look at another chorus drum beat from the 30 Seconds to Mars boys from the song This Is War, drummed by Shannon Leto, or Shannon Leto. Sorry, but still not sure about his pronunciation. You can download the music to go along with this lesson from my website. Just follow the link beneath this video. It'll take you straight to the page where you can find the music for this drum beat. Like I say, it's the chorus drum beat from the song This Is War. It's two bars long. We're playing four beats to every bar, so it's counted one and two and three and four and. And throughout the two-bar pattern, Shannon's playing up on the crash cymbal. He's playing quarter notes up on the crash cymbal with his right hand. And all quarter notes are, you're basically playing on every beat of the bar, beats one, two, three, and four. You're not playing on the ands. You'll be counting the ands, but you won't be playing on the ands. The notes in between each crash are the ands. And we're playing just on the beat of the bar. One, two, three, four, or one, and two, and three, and one, and two, and three, and four, and. I had my brain in triplet mode there from a previous video. One, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and. And to play this correctly, you've got to learn how to do some syncopated stuff with the bass drum and snare drum. So we're playing a steady flow of notes, quarter notes, with the right hand, and the bass drum and snare drum will be playing around underneath that. And Shannon's chosen to play a rather common idea. You might hear this idea being played through 16th notes, in this case it's being played through 8th notes. We're playing a group of three, but it resolves very quickly near the end of the bar each time. But we've got both bars starting with this same snare drum, bass drum pattern. It's basically, we're playing one, two, three. Snare, bass, bass, snare, bass, bass. They're the first six notes of both bars. One and two and three and. One and two and three and. One and two and three and, which is fair enough. But with the right hand at the same time, it can be quite tricky to line up correctly. So in order to be able to nail this drum beat, you've only got to really practice two types of patterns. The first type is where the snare drum, the first note of the three, one, two, three, comes down with the crash cymbal. So you can see that written on the music, one and two, the first bar. We get one and two. First snare drum comes down with a crash, bass drum on its own, then the second bass drum with the crash. One and two. The second pattern you need to be able to play comfortably is where the snare drum starts in between the crash cymbals. And you can see the example of that on the and of two, and three and. So we, just for the sake of practicing it, we're gonna play a crash on its own and then the snare drum coming in on the and, like this. Two and three and. So you can see the snare drum goes in between the crashes on the and then the first of the two bass drum notes comes down with the crash, and then the second bass drum note falls in between the crash again. So that's the harder one of the two to practice, because you've got it starting in between the crashes and you've got a bass drum note, the second of the two bass drum notes, ending in between the crashes as well. Two and three and. Two and three and. Now I'm leaving out the bass drum on beat two just for the sake of practice. Two and three and. So put those two patterns together and you've got the bass, you've basically got the first three quarters of the bar. But of course, you have to play it slowly and line up the notes with the right hand carefully. Let's have a go at that now, shall we? Easier for me to show you, I think. One and two and three and. So we had the one and two straight into and three and. One and two and three and. Or one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. One, two, three, one, two, three. One and two and three and. One and two and three and. So there's the final little loop that you might like to practice. Just those three beats there. Loop that round until you feel comfortable with that. One and two and three and. 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 Then for the last beat of bar one, we have these three snare drum notes in a row, because it goes into beat one of the next bar. We have four and one, four and one. So three snare drum notes. The first of the three starts with a crash, then a snare drum note on its own on the and of four, and then the next snare drum with the crash on beat one. Four and one. And the beat one of the next bar is the first of the three notes. So we get four and one and two. Basically, that last snare drum note, the four and one, that note there on the snare drum is the first of the three we just practiced, where we get snare, bass, bass. So it loops around nicely. Four and one, four and one and two. Four and one and two. And it loops around again, like I say. So the second bar is exactly the same thing again. We get one and two and three and. And then instead of four and one again, we just get four and. So snare drum on four, bass drum on the and of four. Four and. So the second bar, in fact, let me just go back a step. Let me play the first bar on its own very slowly for you. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one. There's the first bar. The second bar, when you loop it, sounds slightly different. One and two and three and four and one and two. That's the difference between the two bars. The only difference between the two bars. So let me try putting the two bars together now slowly for you. One and two and three and four and 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 one. Even slower perhaps. Let me count myself in as well. Three and four and one and two and 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 three and four and one.
Let me try that again without counting, so you can hear what the drum beat sounds like, perhaps a little bit faster.
Three and four and. Faster still. And faster still. So if you're still finding that difficult, and who wouldn't, if you're average beginner drummer, that's quite tricky to get that syncopation between the quarter notes and what the bass drum and snare drum are doing, because you're basically playing a steady beat here and you're playing a pattern with, between the bass drum and snare drum that's going against what the right hand is playing. It's like two rhythms going on, if you like. So that is a little bit tricky to get used to, but if you line up the notes carefully one by one and practice it slowly, then that shouldn't be too difficult for people to get. But what you can do, if you are still finding that difficult, is you can instead play eighth notes on the crash cymbal. So instead of leaving these gaps on the ands with the right hand, you play all the notes. One and two and three and four and. It doesn't sound particularly nice on an electric drum kit crash cymbal, but on a real cymbal, you can get that to kind of wash out. And what that means is that you don't have to really worry about leaving gaps and bass drum notes and snare drum notes falling in between. What you do is you just play all the bass drum and snare drum notes with a crash cymbal. So exactly the same thing again now, but I'm just going to play the crash cymbal on every single note. It's not what Shannon plays, but it's a workaround. If you can't get the quarter notes, then at least you can have a go playing it this way and you can play along to the song. Like this. One and two and three and four and 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 one. So now you might be thinking, well, why doesn't Shannon play it that way if that's easier? Well, there's probably a couple of reasons. The main reason being that the tempo is quite fast. And so if you're comfortable playing quarter notes, and most drummers have been playing for a few years can play quarter notes quite comfortably, then it's easier because you're playing less notes and you know, you're giving your right arm a chance to rest. The other reason is that, like I say, if you're playing lots of notes on a crash cymbal, it tends to wash out a bit over too much. Leave a bit of space between each crash cymbal, and it sounds better. It sort of mixes in, the individual notes mix in together better, that they have a chance to wash out over each other, rather than this where you get rather than lots of notes. So that's the second reason. Plus the third reason is it sounds cooler, and it's, you know, good fun to be able to play a quarter note drum beat. And be able to like syncopate it around what the right hand's doing. It feels good, it sounds good, it tastes good. So yeah, there you go, that's a little workaround for you. You can play eighth notes if you find that really difficult. Email me if you've got any questions or problems with that, as always. I hope you found that enjoyable. I hope you have fun having a go at it. Please do have a go at it. It is a good fun drum beat to have a go at. And catch you next time.